Inshallah, we'll go ahead and start the class. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So, we will study ayah number 125 of Surah Al-Baqarah today. And this ayat is basically about the establishment of the Kaaba, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam, his son, to take care of few things in the Kaaba. And that's what this ayah is about. So let me do a brief translation. The ayah starts with Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wa idh ja'alna al-bayta. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here, and when we made the house. Al-bayt means the house. And this house is the Kaaba. So Allah says, and when we made the house, masabatan linnas. Masabatan is a place where people can go and come back. Okay, people can go and come back and visit again. So linnas means for the people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Kaaba, al-bayt, a place where people can come visit, perform their prayers, they go back and then they come again. That's the meaning of masabatan. And then the next part is wa amna, and the place of peace. So the Kaaba is the place of peace also. Okay? That is what aman or amna means. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we instructed Ibrahim and Ismail to do something. And there is a place inside which is called the Maqam Ibrahim, which is a special area, a small area inside the boundaries of the Kaaba, outside the black cube, which is called Maqam Ibrahim. So people who go for Hajj or Umrah, they pray two rakats next to the Maqam Ibrahim. So that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. وَاتَّخِذُوا, and this is addressing all the people, take or make Maqam Ibrahim, the station of Ibrahim, that is small area which is called Maqam Ibrahim inside the Kaaba, as Musalla. Musalla means the place to pray. So go and perform a small, short amount, like two rakats or four rakats of prayer when you go for Hajj or Umrah, in that little area. That's called Maqam Ibrahim, and make it a musalla. So people, when they go there for Hajj or Umrah or any other visitation, they make sure that they go and perform two rakats or four rakats of salat in that section.
Just the only little area?
That is a little, I would say it's about this wide, and this tall, and there are some stones inside. And that is, historically, that is the rock or stone upon which Ibrahim alayhi salam stood and built the Kaaba.
I heard that it's a footprint of it.
That is what it is, yeah. So wherever that is located, it's a little further from the Kaaba, like few, I would say about less than 100 yards from the black cube, in the direction of Hadra Aswad. So people go and stand and perform two rakats there. So this is what the Quran says, Maqam Ibrahim, take the Maqam Ibrahim, the place that is station of Ibrahim, as Musalla, as the place where you perform two rakats or four rakats of salat. Okay? Then Allah says, Wa ahidna ila Ibrahima, and we commanded Ibrahim, Wa Ismail, and his son Ismail, both of them. Because these two were the ones who actually built the Kaaba. They put the bricks of the Kaaba together and made the Kaaba. So Allah says that after the Kaaba was built, okay, Allah says, we took the Ahad, or we commanded Ibrahim and Ismail, Antahira, that they should keep clean. They should keep pure. Tahira is purification. Baitiya, my house. The the house of Allah. Keep the house of Allah clean. For what? Lit-ta'ifina. Lit-ta'ifina is the people who do tawaf, they are called ta'ifin. So people who go around the Kaaba, this is the action of tawaf. The person who goes around, he is called ta'if. And the plural of this ta'ifina means all the people who want to go around the Kaaba, they are called ta'ifin. So keep my house clean for those people who come there and do the tawaf. Wal akifina. Akifina is from akif. Akif means one who sits down in a corner. Etikaf. The word etikaf. So those people who go there and do the etikaf, keep the house clean for them also. Wal rukka is sujood, and those people who want to make ruku there, and those people who want to make sajda. So these are all the acts of worship. So when people go in there, these are the only things they are supposed to do. They should pray, which is making ruku and sajda. They should go and do the tawaf. Or they should sit down in some corner and do the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is itikaf. So these are the activities. So Allah says that we instructed Ibrahim and Ismail, keep the house clean for these people who will come. So that is the meaning of the ayah. Okay?
And we have to do the nafil around the Kaaba, the area that is next to the Kaaba?
No. When is the time for the prayer? Pray there. Even five times prayer are performed there. So when the time for the prayer comes, then stand and make the prayer. And then after that, continue the tawaf.
Nafil too.
No, you can you pray all kind of prayer there, but also you can do the itikaf there and make sajda and ruku. Sajda and ruku may be nafil or fard or sunnah or any kind of prayer. Okay, so this is the explanation.
What she is saying is correct. After they make the tawaf, they come and make two rakat nafil at this location, which is
Maqam Ibrahim. Yes. Yes, that's what I said.
That's what you wanted.
Yeah. No, I'm saying like where around the Kaaba is that used to be Kaaba used to be a triangle.
The box is quite.
Now it's just the box. So what I'm saying, like the area that is, this area, what I heard that it's good to do nafil too.
Well, you're not supposed to go in the inside of the Hatim.
No, people go there. I mean, it's full always.
Yeah.
No, that
time to go.
There. No, no, not in between the.
Yeah, not in between Kaaba and Hatim.
We go to
Hatim,
we pray there.
Yeah, pray there.
I don't know. No, that's, you're talking the outside of the feet, the foot.
So here. Okay, this is the Kaaba. Okay. This is Hajra Aswad. This is Maqam Ibrahim.
Yeah.
And this is Hatim.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're not supposed to be in between these two.
No. Yeah, yeah, people pray there. Because no.
People go there.
Maybe they do now and
why
haven't they?
Yeah.
No, or
they say
you can pray there now.
Yes, I thought they, because that's the original.
The reason was that the reason I tell you was that it is suspected that there are some graves under there.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly.
So that is the reason you are not supposed to pray in this area.
No.
All the deeper
there, I saw.
The deeper down. That is the reason.
I pray in that area too.
So that's. But usually people go around this.
Somebody says like you are doing nafal inside the car. If you do nafal, no, if you do nafal in that area, it seems like you are doing inside.
Okay, so wallah alam. But that's the reason that there are probably some.
No, actually, if people pass away, they carry that come and put it there, so they don't let you sit there.
And one more question, I'm sorry, the Hajra Aswad came and joined
No, Hajra Aswad was placed in this wall by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It was lifted by him and mounted there.
Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Ibrahim Alaihi.
No, not by Ibrahim Alaihi Wasallam. It used to be outside, and the leaders of the Quraysh, they wanted the honor of putting the Hajra Aswad on the wall of the Kaaba, and they could not agree. So they said, the next person who walks in, we will give him the honor of lifting it and mounting here. So it just happened that Prophet ﷺ walked in there. So he lifted that and he mounted there. But this stone used to be there for a very long time.
I think they found it when they were digging for the well or something.
Probably, yeah.
No, the thing
so
was...
So anyway, let...
How big is the Maqam Ibrahim?
Maqam Ibrahim is just like a small vertical box, this tall, and I guess this wide.
So people just, can get in?
No, not get inside. They just go around it, buy it, and pray there.
So Maqam Ibrahim, the Prophet Ibrahim, what he did, he was praying.
So it is said, historically, it is said that when he was building the walls of the Kaaba here, originally, there was a stone here that he would stand on this and he would put the bricks of the Kaaba, and Ismail alayhi salam was helping him. So that piece of rock, stone, and there is some footprint on this, is supposed to be the first footprint of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So that piece of rock has been preserved there. Okay. Wow. Now it has been moved somewhere here, and a tower has been put around it, a glass tower.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so people are supposed to go and pray two rakats here, Maqam Ibrahim.
So this is what they call Maqam Ibrahim.
This is called Maqam Ibrahim or the Station of Ibrahim. Yeah, this is small box there.
I think there's a gold frame around it.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me get back to what the ayah says. So the ayah starts Wa'id Ja'alna Wa means and Id means when. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about some historical time and when. Okay. And the next word is Jim, Ayan, and Lam. And the meaning of it is to make. Okay.
Is there extra coffee for the mother or something? Yeah, I need extra coffee, please.
I think I have to do that.
What
do you
do?
I don't think I
can. So, Jim Ayan Lam means to make. Okay? And if we look on the table here, if you have these three letters, Fa, N, and Lam, and you make the word Fa'alna, that means we did. Okay, so in the grammar, when you put a Na after the three letters and sound like Fa'alna, it means we did. So if we do with these three letters, it will be Ja'alna. Ja'alna means we made. Okay? So what is Ja'alna? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and when we made. We here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We made or we appointed. Okay? So what is Ja'alna means and when, sometime in the past, we made. Allah made something here. And what did He make here? Al-Bayt. So, Bayt means a house. So the word is, original word is Baytun. Baytun means a house. Baytun means a house. And if you put al before that, it will become al baytu. Because al takes out one dhamma from here, so it becomes al baytu. And it becomes the, instead of a house, it becomes the house. So this is, now we talk about some particular house. Okay? And this house means Kaaba. Okay? So Allah says, and when we made the house, okay? And the house is Kaaba. That's the reason we say Baitullah is the house of Allah. Baitullah, house of Allah, al-Bait means the house. So when and when we made the house, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the house? Is this word Mathabatan. So the root letters for this is Sa, Ba, Sa, Vav, and Ba. This means to return to origin. Return to origin. Means if you came from somewhere, you go back there. That means to return to the origin. Tha, Vav, and Ba. From this, the word Masabatun is created. Masabatun with two dhammas. This means a place to return. A place where you go back. So this is a place of return. What does it mean? That Kaaba is a place where you go, you perform the prayers, you go back. Then you come again there. Whenever you have the opportunity, you come back there again and you do all the things there, Tawaf and Hajj and Umrah, and then you go back. And then when you get the opportunity, you come back again. So it's a place where you keep going back and forth, returning back and forth. Okay? So that is, Allah says that we appointed this house, Kaaba, so people can come and go and visit this place. Okay? Not supposed to be permanently live inside. Okay? They visit, do the necessary rituals, and then they go back, and then they come back again. Okay? So that is the meaning of place of return.
If you put alif after waw, please.
Yeah, so the root letters for thawab, okay, the word thawab that we know. Thawab. When you do something, you will get some thawab of that, right? Okay. What thawab means that? You do good some good deed. In return, you get something else. So the word return is the...
Oh, yeah.
Okay? So that is what the sawabun means, that you do some action. In return, you get something back from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's called sawab. Okay? So the root letter. Also the thawb, which is the cloth, is from the same root letter. So same root letters may have multiple meanings. Okay? But here, masabatun is a place where you return. Okay? So place of return. Okay. So the next word is, and we looked at this last time, Nas. Nasun means pupil. Mm-hmm. And when we put the al before that, it means the pupil. Al means the. And it becomes an-nasu. Because when you read it together, you don't pronounce the lam, you pronounce noon twice. And one dhamma goes away, so this becomes an-nasu. The pupil, and when you put lam with the kasra, that means four, Okay? And for or li is a harfijar, this changes this dhumma to into a kasra, so it becomes linnasi. When you read, you combine this lam with this linnasi, with the noon.
So is people a good word or mankind, should we say?
When both are okay.
Both,
yeah. For the people. Yeah, because mankind is used for all the people. So all the people will not be going there. Linnas, for the people. Okay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ, and we, when we made the house means the Kaaba, مَثَابَةَ لِلنَّاسِ, a place for the people to come and visit and go back and come back and visit again and go back. Okay? Keep coming and going, returning. So that is one purpose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning here. The other one is amnan. Amnan here is from the alif, mim, noon, and amnun means peace. Amnun is the root letter, root word, means peace. Okay? And because Allah has made this place, it's a maful or object, and when we make the object, two dhummas changes to two fathas. So it becomes amnun, and whenever there is two fathas, we put an extra alif here. So that is the way it is written in the Quran. And peace. So a house of a peace, al-bayt will apply to this also. And when we made the house as a place of peace and a place for the people to come back. Okay? Kaaba. So this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling my people that this is what we have done. Okay, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding people to do something, which is wattakhizu. Okay. So the word is waw, which means and this other word is with a kasra, ittakhizu. Ittakhizu. So these are from the letters akhaza, are the three root letters. Three letters we know that belong to the group of the words which are called fa'ala, three letters. Okay. This means to draw something, but this is not the word that we are going to use here. When we say natija akhz, it means draw a conclusion. Okay, so that is the, but the word that is created is from a different bab, which is called ifta'ala. Okay, so this becomes ittakhaza. Ittakhaza means to take. So meaning changes, ittakhaza, the word ittakhaza is the root word, it means to take something.